One thing that's super interesting is your series of paintings with the water droplets windshield. And I remember I saw you create the first one that you ever did. Yeah. You were so thrilled about it. I've seen it develop over the years. How have you kind of
thank you, yeah. I remember doing those plein airs. We're very young, Allison, but it's a while ago.
We were stuck in our cars, it was raining, and you just painted the windshield.
Yeah, I've been doing them. It developed very organically of just, you know, it's raining, we had to figure out something to paint, and I really got excited about checking out each little raindrop and how that abstracted the scene of what I'm painting, and you know, it helped that it was successful, that people bought it and liked it, but I kept doing it, and I do think I've grown
and
a lot.
It's changed, yeah.
Yeah, I keep looking for different reasons to paint the raindrops. Like in this show, I have more higher chroma ones, more colorful ones, because, you know, when it's raining, it's a very dreary day, typically. And I was trying to figure out ways to add color to them, so I envisioned being on a cruise, a ship, and you know, it's maybe a sunset, but that water from the ocean splashing up on the little portholes, and that was a way to like get raindrops on something that could be sunny. So the scenes are like sunsets and sunrises, and they're much more colorful. So yeah, always just playing with different ways to twist those ideas.
Totally.
So, I mean, you do that often too, of just like we have these certain motifs for outdoor painting or whatever, and like it's like jazz, you know, you got this standard thing that, you know, people have been doing for centuries, but how can you twist it? How can you keep finding it interesting?
Right, so make it your own.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, so.
Yeah, very cool.
Thanks.